package having various yoga abhyas in the order of priority. Although there are three main yoga abhyas, which are practiced by everyone in our yoga classes, these include Ardhasana, Padavrittasana, and Dvichakrikasana mainly. But today, we are going to practice three asanas in sitting posture. After these three asanas, we will practice two more in standing position, and then five more asanas in lying position. Among these three asanas we keep recommending from time to time. We are going to add two more today, especially for thyroid and throat problems. They are Sarvangasana and Halasana. Practice them if you can. Of these 10 asanas, if you are able to practice even three, you will remain healthy. But the reason behind recommending these 10 asanas is to provide 100% surety of getting rid of obesity. And still, if you feel the need, you may take home remedies and change your diet that we will recommend you. So, for the first practice, stretch both your legs in front. You have to perform grinding action. Both the feet join together in front. After joining your feet in front, you make a big circle with both your hands. Both the legs join together in front, like this. Rotate your hands forward and backward. In this manner, making a big circle. In case of lower back pain, do not bend forward. Just take this precaution. Interlock your fingers, join both the feet in the front. Do not lift your knees. They will remain straight. Do not lift your legs even while moving backward. Do not lift your leg like this. Keep them straight on the ground itself. Rotate fully in this manner. Then from opposite direction. This is effective especially to reduce fat from the stomach. Many a times, when you put on weight, first of all, you develop a paunch, thereafter waistline increases, followed by heaviness in hips, and then thighs and buttocks. This practice is effective for all these parts. Earlier, women used to grind in this manner. They used to be slim and smart. These days, they don't indulge in such physical work and sleep a lot in the afternoon. If you want to get rid of obesity, stop sleeping during the day. Develop control over eating habits. Drink lukewarm water in the morning and practice this asana. Make a big circle. Stop eating sweets. Whenever you feel thirsty, drink lukewarm water. Your extra pounds will disappear automatically. Just practice little yoga. Rotate like this. While moving forward, keep hands like this and like this while moving backward. Rotate from behind the toes, taking them over your thighs in this manner. Knees straight and toes stretched outwards. Repeat the same from opposite direction. Do not bend your elbows. Elbows will remain straight. It will not be effective if you rotate while bending your elbows, even if you practice it for 100 times. This was the first practice. Now second asana. Open both the legs in the front. In this posture, practice Kati Saundaryasana. In many cases, due to obesity, the waistline increases so much that the waist disappears totally. Thigh and buttocks also accumulate extra fat. When you see your image in the mirror, you are ashamed of yourself. At the time of birth, we all were gifted with a beautiful body, and by adopting wrong habits, we have made it so ugly. One should keep childhood photograph carefully so that later on, in young age or in old age, one is able to compare and judge what he has done to his body due to laziness and bad habits. Keep both the hands like this. For Kati Saundaryasana, take a deep breath in. In case of lower back pain, do not bend forward. Take a deep breath and hold the big toe of the left foot with your right hand. Your left hand is upward. Look at that and come back to the same position. Then practice from the other side. There are many other benefits of this exercise as well. In case of severe pain in the lower back, practice only so much. Like this. And like this. And like this. While breathing in, bend to a side. Then while breathing out, come back. This is effective especially for reducing your waistline. Extra fats in arms will also reduce. So it will reduce the fat from your waistline, stomach and arms also. Do it like this. You can practice at fast pace also. This was the second asana. Now the third. Pashuvishramasana. Stretch both the legs in front like this. Now fold your left leg from the front. Fold it in such a way that the foot faces outside with ankle facing towards the inner side and toes outside. Now fold your right leg in such a way that the foot rests near the left knee, touching the thigh in such a manner that ankle faces inward and toes remain near the knee. Toes of the right foot will remain in front, close to the left thigh, like this, in this manner. Pashu Vishramasana, specially to reduce the fat deposited on the sides. Deposit of extra fat on the waistline will slowly subside with this. Place both the hands on the knees. And while breathing in, lift your hands up. And while breathing out, bend towards the right side. Palms, forehead and elbows resting on the ground. Then slowly raise them up together. Arms and head will be raised together. Practice the same from the other side. asana can be practiced for 5 times to 50 times, increasing it gradually. Actually, the number of times for which it should be repeated will depend on the severity of your problem. Repeat the same steps from the other side. This is especially to reduce the fat of waistline, to reduce the extra deposits of fats from the stomach area. Fold your right leg from the outside with the toes facing outward and ankle facing towards the inner side. Now rest your left foot in such a way that it touches the right thigh, near the right knee. Rest both the hands on your knees. Now take a deep breath in and lift your arms upward. And while breathing out, bend forward. This practice is especially effective for reducing obesity, and it can be practiced once, twice, thrice, and then up to 5 times. At maximum, you may practice it for 50 times. Each of the asana can be practiced for 5 to 50 times. Raise your hands and head together and bring them down together. Don't raise like this. This would be a wrong method. Bend like this and get up like this. These were 3 asanas in sitting posture to reduce fats. Each one can be practiced for 3 times initially, then 5 times, gradually increasing to 50 times depending on the problem. This, you only have to decide that how much of this practice you need. Now, 2 more asanas in standing position. 2 asanas in standing position to reduce the fat and control the body weight. For the first asana, open your legs at some distance. And after keeping them apart, let's practice Konasana. Bring down your right hand while bending like this. And hold the big toe of your left foot in this manner. Left hand is behind, lifted upward. Look at that like this. Then come back to the same position and practice from the other side. Practice with your breath. The distance between your feet should be so much that you are able to touch properly. If you keep them so far, then you may not be able to touch it. So keep them at optimum distance so as to hold them properly. You can practice it at fast pace as well. Look at the hand raised upward. This is Konasana. And now we are telling you one more special asana known as Tiryaktadasana. This is to reduce the fat deposited on your sides. Practice these 2 asanas in the standing posture. Keep your feet a little apart. Now while breathing in, bend towards your right side. Interlock the fingers of your hands and stretch them upward. Elbows fully straight. Now while breathing in, bend towards the right. Look in the front. Bend to the maximum as much as you can. Bend to your side as much as you can. Knees will remain straight. Do not bend sideways while turning in the front. Bend from your side. If you can bend only so much, then that's enough. It's difficult to bend sideways while turning backward. So bend from the side as much as you can. Bend neither in the front nor in the back. So these were the 2 asanas in standing position to reduce fat.